Thank you, Ken Corley. I think that this motion is timely, and while the motion itself maybe looked in isolation doesn't provide for the ongoing militarisation, I think we have to look at everything that's happening right across Europe. And so this motion is timely given the fact that the 55th Munich Security Conference was held last Friday on the 15th of February, and more than 600 politicians, including about three dozen heads of state and government, and more than 80 ministers, high-ranking military officials and representatives from business, science and international organisations met this weekend in Bavaria's capital to discuss international security and defence policy in Europe. Chillingly, at the meeting, the High Representative of the EU for Foreign Affairs and Security Policy and Vice President of the EU Commission quoted, to our soft power, we are finally adding hard power. Furthermore, the new Franco-German Treaty signed last month represented what was what Merkel described as a step toward the creation of a future European army. The language of war is getting coarser. Europe is no longer attempting to disguise its intent with means, which means we are at a terrifying impasse. War is becoming normalised now. Angela Merkel said of the Franco-German pact that it solidifies the common military culture between the two countries. That military culture has now become normalised thanks to governments like this one, who participated in legitimising military projects like PESCO, using language of denial to mask the reality of violence it intends to inflict, and allowing our own terms of neutrality and peacekeeping to be exploited in its name. The proposal put forward today seeks further approval for Ireland to participate in relation to military search capability building. You have confirmed that the Defence Force is engaged extensively in specialised military search operations, dealing with unexploded ordnance, improvised explosive devices and ensuring a so-called safe and secure operating environment for military operations. Who are the military operations that we're ensuring safety for? Ireland can no longer bury its head in the sand here. We are already neck deep in the common military culture as dictated by France and Germany. Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil have already signed up Ireland, and now the Labour Party are part of it as well, I see, signed up Ireland to become a pawn in a very lucrative chess game, even more so since Brexit negotiations took place. Ireland will continue to justify and contribute to the European Defence Agency in exchange for EU support through the Brexit negotiations. German Franco-military interests seek to develop their defence industries further so they can control EU defence policy while globally competing with US and Russian defence companies. Global security will in turn secure Franco-German influence at home and Europe. Let's not forget here how this undermines democracy, militarisation, EU defence integration and the overall global militarisation agenda is being pushed and shaped by private sector interests. Ireland can be sure that it will be paying for the privilege both financially and politically for some time to come.
Thank you, Deputy.
Thank you.
Deputy Eamon Ryan, please.
I think anyone on any side of this House would like to deprive our Irish military with real capabilities in regard to military search capabilities, with regard to dealing with unexploded